Since cinema's birth, the moving camera has been a key component in visual storytelling, serving the story in an almost subliminal manner through various movements, compositions, and angles. The aim of the moving camera was never to draw attention to itself, but instead draw the viewer into the world of the narrative, showcased in the following examples. Number 1, Requiem for a Dream, Marion in the Elevator. Requiem for a Dream, directed by Darren Aronofsky, follows four characters struggling with addiction, causing them to become imprisoned in a world of delusion and desperation. This is where we find Marion in this iconic shot. The shot is achieved by rigging a device known as a snorricam to the actress's body. The camera directly faces the actor and is used to capture Marion's raw reaction to her trauma. The camera itself doesn't move, but is subjected to the movements of the actor, leaving them in focus and causing the surrounding environment to be distorted and unsteady. The camera is motivated by Marion's subjective journey, slowing to pause as she waits for the elevator in the throes of nausea, and quickening in her haste to rush outside and vomit. It's jerky, spasmodic, and explores her broken subjectivity better than any regular POV. The shot changes between front and back facing as she enters the elevator to show us how small and crowded the space is, making us feel extremely claustrophobic and uncomfortable. The film itself takes place in a time when the growth of technology was exponential, cell phones and the internet allowing us to be more connected than we ever were. This is why the use of the snorricam was so popular. It bridged our own subjective experiences with the protagonists in the movies we watched. I chose this shot as it showcases how successfully the moving camera can be used to elicit both a physical and mental response from the audience. Aronofsky's use of the snorricam is enough to draw you into the story completely without overpowering you. Number 2. The Two Popes, the Piano Scene. The Two Popes, directed by Fernando Meirelles, follows the imagined conversations between two very different men about the role of the church in a changing world. The cinematography stood out so much I couldn't focus on or finish the movie, making it a natural choice to explore when dissecting the nature of the moving camera. The handheld crash zooms in the piano scene are a perfect example of what makes the moving camera unsuccessful and why. DOP Cesare Carlone shot the scene by utilizing nimble handheld cameras and light telephoto lenses to enable him to move quickly and organically around the actors. It was filmed with the aim of looking and feeling like a documentary, but the almost comedic crash zooms and shaky cam come off as overtly voyeuristic rather than documentative.
You went to Abbey Road?
No, it would not have been appropriate.
The structure of the scene is fragmented and messy. Both characters are constantly reframed with no goal or purpose in mind. The camera pulling focus between them without clear dialogue cues and crash zooming into their faces. The camera constantly uses not only the characters, but every set piece available to influence the shot. We are overwhelmed by different setups and have endless exposure to new and unnecessary aspects of the production design. We feel like an intruder in their conversations, and it's deeply uncomfortable. Carlone was hoping to use the distinct difference in filming style to portray the passage of time, using a stiller frame and flashbacks to mirror how films were shot in that era. This contrasts the handheld method of the rest of the film, emphasizing how nimble and light modern technology is nowadays. Number 3, Euphoria Episode 1, The Hallway Scene. Sam Levinson's Euphoria follows a group of high school students through their experiences with sex, drugs, friendships, and identity. Showrunners have said that the show's aesthetic style and omniscient camera presence were to parallel the teenage social experience of today, ensuring everything was filtered and perfectly curated to hide the characters' flaws. The hallway scene utilizes a delicious cocktail of dolly tracks and subtle rolls. It's an extremely successful example of the moving camera motivated by the main character Rue's drug use. We begin in a bathroom, straight standing and surrounded by mirrors. Rue is sober, so naturally there is little to no camera movement. As we follow her exit from the bathroom, there's a slightly more rapid pan to the right, indicating the drugs have entered her system. The camera tracks Rue through the hallway towards the stairs, slow and dreamlike, rolling as she rolls through a series of perfectly executed and incredibly subtle tilts. Rue is reframed constantly, as if we are just as out of focus as she is. This is another shot that showcases a character's downward journey that I thought was a brilliant example of practical effects and clever camera work. Mirroring Christopher Nolan's Inception, production design created a room on a gimbal that rotated. The bathroom was a separate set piece that breaks away when Rue exits, allowing a techno crane to dolly into the hallway with her as the entire hallway begins to rotate. Each of the partygoers are strapped to the ground as Levinson decided that comping them in post would take the life out of the scene. DOP Marcel Rev did an astounding job with this scene, so I'm super happy to finish on such a brilliant example of artistry. Thanks so much for watching.